I'm changing the content slightly as my face week after week can get a tad boring. Today I have with me the fabulous Lisa Snowden, who is my friend, model and TV presenter. She's going to be my muse and I'm going to do a really beautiful, natural, fresh makeup on Lisa. First product I'm going to use is the Veil Primer by Hourglass. Use a primer when you're applying a really natural makeup because even though it's natural, you still want it to last. This primer is oil-free, glides on beautifully, sits over the pores, giving you a smooth surface for your base.
So I noticed that you just put the primer on the T-zone.
Yeah, don't put too much product on, you don't need to. I put it around the T-zone because that's where I want the product to last the most, and that's where you've got bigger pores on your complexion.
Okay, got it.
Next, we're going to use the Face Finishing Moisturiser. This is from Perico. Now, this is one product that adapts on your skin, so I'm going to get you to do it yourself.
I love this
put
one.
Put your finger in.
I love it.
So you just apply, always apply from your T-zone outwards. That means you get most product in the areas you need coverage for.
Like this?
Yeah, exactly. You don't need to use a brush. The quickest way to get these products onto your skin in a natural way is through the warmth of your finger.
How close to the eyes?
All the way.
Really?
All the way over.
See, I love this because it's got a little bit of a tint, hasn't it? So it sort of melts into the skin.
Yeah. It's very similar to a Wasso makeup product that I've used before, but this is just slightly more honeyish, and because you've got a lovely warm undertone to your skin, I wanted to use this one, but it really gives you the glow of like 2 days in the sun.
It really does, isn't it? Always up, Caroline, always up.
Always up.
Moisturiser.
So nice and fresh, not too heavy. Now I'm going to use a little bit of concealer. Now this is a beautiful concealer. It's by Bourjois. I'm going to apply it with a very small brush. Find. Now I'm applying it with a brush that is synthetic. Look up for me, Lise. I'm just going to use this just around your eye area and just around the nose, and I'm going to blend it out. Now these are the darker areas of your face, so what makeup does is just lift and even out the tones in your skin. So that's eradicating any redness, lifting any darkness, brightening any dark areas. If your skin looks even, you just look really polished and finished.
I don't like too much on my skin, so just, I love the fact that you're just putting it where I need it.
Exactly.
Rather than just a whole face of base.
And so long as you've got the right amount of product in the right place, you don't need to. And you want to have that glow. You want your skin to look really fresh. And this Bourjois product really sits well into the skin. It blends well with the Perico moisturiser. And just adds a little bit of lift. Now this colour that I've used here is 52 medium. And it's just a little bit lighter than the colour on your body here. And a little bit lighter than the Perico's giving you. So it's giving you instant dimension to your face.
It's lovely.
So close your eyes, Lee, and I'm just going to take the same product over your lid too. Now this dries matte as well. There's nothing worse than having a very kind of greasy, creamy concealer because one, it's not going to last very long. Two, it will go into the creases of your eye. And three, once it's matte, it creates a lovely soft base for you to apply on your future colour.
Because it's matte, you still need to powder to set it, or not as much?
It depends whether you've got naturally oily lids. If you find that your lids are actually quite oily naturally, then absolutely a little bit of fine powder on top will kind of absorb that excess oil. Depending what you're doing, you can leave your eyes like that so they can be a bit glossy. You can maybe use a cream eyeshadow, so it just depends on how you feel. But just make sure it's fine so it doesn't shrink the skin and age the skin.
Okay.
Right, so I've done the concealer now, and that's all you need. One thing I would suggest when you're doing a natural makeup or even quite a strong makeup, just remove the makeup from some of your nose. Like that is the most prominent feature. And if you've got a very powdery nose, it instantly makes you look made up.
Okay.
Now, if you've got a little bit of pigmentation, you just need to go in with the same brush. This is a slightly thicker concealer. This is by Cover FX, and I love the palette. I'm just going to show you the little palette here.
Great colours.
Great colours and a lovely highlighter I'm going to show you. But just very delicately, I mean, your skin's amazing, I have to say.
Being very kind.
Just over that area there. That's
all
you need,
that
extra bit. And just a little bit on the other side. So again, just lifting that area.
Is this quite a thick, but is it like a studio, is it like a professional studio kind of base?
No, not at all, because you can thin it out.
Right.
So I'm just using it very thinly and then just using my finger to blend it in. But of course, you can go in really heavy with it, and I use it when I'm filming too, but it's just nice for those really stubborn areas that you want to conceal without it looking really heavy. But the number two one here, it's got a really beautiful sheen to it. So just here, I'm going to use that there so it catches the light and gives you a lovely glow. Now adding any kind of light to the skin in the right place makes us look younger, fresher, And it's just around the top of the eyebrow, over the peak of the cheekbone. You can feel the circle of your skull there, so it's just on that high part of the cheekbone there that you press it into if you get a bit lost. Don't take
it
too close.
I love that look. I love it. Look at that. It's just like picking up that light and it gives it that lovely dewy look.
Like you're super healthy.
Yeah.
Have loads of facials and drink green juice
all day long. And the thing is, as you do get older, you don't want the makeup to sit here, and it has to be that lovely, more creamy consistency,
yeah,
doesn't it?
And that diffuses those fine lines.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas if it's dry, you see the bumps in the skin.
Yeah.
Whereas this just kind of gives you that lovely kind of sheen.
Gorgeous.
Add a little bit of light to the nose, but just keep it where the bone is there, not on the tip. Keep the tip just sort of nice and semi-matte. Otherwise, it kind of makes your nose too prominent.
Yeah.
You push it back a little. Next thing, you use the Tom Ford Shade and Illuminate Stick. So I just love double-ended products, right? And this just screams Lisa. Beautiful kind of like metallic bronze, which I'm just going to place right across your cheek. Again, super, super soft. Don't take it too high and blend it down. So you don't want to get rid of this beautiful light we've created around your eye, and just blend that down. And on the other side, it's got this lovely kind of coral flush to it. Just again, blend the bronze down under the cheekbone, and it's just not too red or too orangey, this tone, which I love because it looks super natural. Now, this is the colour that I love because you've got a little bit of natural redness in your skin. So by using more of a corally colour, just on the apple of your cheeks and blend it in, it sort of neutralises that little bit, but it just looks fresher. If we're doing a natural makeup, these kind of bronzy tones, I think it's always nice to have just a bit of, you like that noise.
Love it. It just makes it really youthful, and it just lifts your face, and just, I just love it because it's really careful layering, but really light touch, and just the lovely luminous quality of this product. It just really makes the skin look so healthy and fresh.
Yeah, beautiful. So we've kept the eye area. I always kind of get people to imagine they've got a big pair of designer sunglasses on, so the concealer is still nice and light, and you've got the colour on your cheeks, and it just kind of adds the warmth there, which really instantly makes the whites of your eyes look bigger, and we haven't even done anything with your eyes. So again, that's really, really soft. So once you've done all your cream products, then you need to move on to your powder. Now, I'm going to be using the Hyaluronic Powder by Terry. Now, this is a white powder. I'm going to apply it with a puff. A translucent powder that just literally becomes invisible on the skin, but it's got hyaluronic in it. And if I just get you to touch my hand, just feel how soft that is.
It's like silk.
Like silk.
So fine.
So again, it doesn't age the skin. Now I'm just going to place it in between the brows, either side of the nose here. Really, really push it in, and just under the chin. I'm going to take a little brush and then just blend that in, and it just disappears. Just pressing it in gives a little bit more longevity to the powder, so you get that nice mattness to your skin. Keeping it matte down the centre and glossy on the outside really helps to really boost and beautify your face shape.
And that will last all day?
Well, it depends what you're doing. I mean, not if you're going to go and run a marathon, you know, it might be slightly challenged, but you know, of a normal day, you're going to get much more long wear out of that. Keep the rest of the skin glowy, and it just gives a beautiful dimension to your bone structure.
Love it. Perfect base.
So now we're going to go on to brows. Now I'm going to use a brow gel first. I'm just going to bring the brows right in the centre up, and give great lift to them. If I'm lifting them first, just with a clear gel, I can then see where I need to fill in. Now you've got really great brows, I have to say. I don't have to do too much work with them, but I can just fill in, and I can just lift slightly, because it's a natural makeup. I don't want the brows to be really heavy, because then it dominates your eye and the beauty of your eye disappears.
Just a few little sparse areas, aren't there? From years of overplucking.
So I'm going to fill in these areas here just to create a little bit of strength. I'm going to use the Max Factor's Brow Shaper, and I like this because it's propelling, and two, the colour is really nice. It's got like a sort of grey tone to it. I'm not going as dark as Lisa's actual natural brow, because then it would look again too dense.
Mm.
And because it's very fine, it doesn't leave a lot of product. So filling in that brow there and doing fine little hair-like strokes, so it's just like super natural. And I quite like the graduation of colour there. I don't think you need anything too strong, because it then shrinks that area. Anything dark on your face is going to make everything look smaller.
So you want to open that up.
Exactly.
Okay.
Whereas if I was doing a really intense eye on you, I'd put lots and lots of black towards your lash line. But here we want it open and fresh, so just delicate shape. So again, just under here. This creates almost like a natural shadow, like a thickening to to Lisa's brows. I'm just using the shape of her eye here to know how far I can elongate her brow.
So important.
Well, as we get older, it's the structure of our face that needs to be resharpened. You know, your brows, your lashes, your bone structure, and then whatever lip colour, blush colour, eye colour, it just becomes like the fun decoration. If you get the nice structure in your face, then you can do whatever you like. So natural makeup, cream eyeshadow. I mean, it's just the easiest way to add shape to your eye.
Quick as well, really
super
quick.
Super quick, yeah. And no product coming down on your cheeks.
Perfect.
If you could just close your eyes for me. Now, I'm going to use this pencil here by Nude Stick. This is a great shade. Now, it's slightly metallic, which really helps catch the light and shape your eye. The most important thing is to really wedge the colour along the lash line first and then take it up into the socket. Now, this is really soft, this product, and it stays put once dry. There's no excuse not to be able to shape your eye with, and you've got products like this that work so well.
Great colour.
So once you've applied it, then just take a clean eyeshadow brush and just soften the edge into the socket. You want to keep the skin under the eyebrow just nice and clean and fresh, just put a little bit of that concealer on. Don't use any more colours, just keep it very simple. I really think that simple structured makeup looks so modern.
Love it. Beautiful.
Now, I also like that this colour isn't brown, because I've used the warmth in your skin. If I then know it for something that was really golden and brown, it would all just look a bit sort of muddy. But it's quite nice that even if you're using like a tonal makeup, close your eyes for me, that you're actually using different washes of tones. So again, really wedge the colour on it. It feels soft.
Yeah. Absolutely. Just glides on. And it's interesting because I would usually use either sort of caramelly, bronzy colours rather than this sort of because I feel that this is quite a cold grey,
yeah.
And I wouldn't necessarily think as a sort of dewy, daytime, glossy golden look, I wouldn't go for a grey, but actually, and with my eye colour,
really nice,
makes them really blue.
So perfect, let's take it under there and do the last blend. And it's kind of thick enough, this product, that it doesn't blend. Sometimes you can use cream eyeshadows that are really slippery. You're like, oof, and then it kind of spreads, and then you just can't get the product to really fix. But that's lovely and really, really simple.
Really nice.
Right, so natural makeup, we need lift. So you have to curl your eyelashes. So I'm going to get you to do it yourself.
Always. There's always no point in putting on mascara unless you curl your lashes. Yes. Even if you're not wearing mascara, curl your lashes.
Yeah.
Girls and guys.
Yeah, and like. Guys.
Guys
yeah.
too. I mean, maybe not my fiancé, George, but some guys out there will.
Does he not have very long lashes then?
If I attacked him with one of these, he'd run a mile.
Careful not to push that too hard into your cheek. It's being delicate with your face.
It's like years of doing it, just ramming in the eyelash curler. Gentle. So when you do it, you go really gently.
Well, I don't press. That's it. You just lift.
There we
that's
go.
All. Great. Okay.
I literally...
Calm.
No, I'm a bit heavy-handed with them, aren't I? It's because I've been doing... I can do it without a mirror. It's literally... This has been the best tool for my
one of those essential tools
life.
That makes a difference.
Sorry, it's a bit brutal.
So this is my favourite mascara combo. Now, you might think it's a natural look, so I really should have a natural mascara. No. And we're going to do lifting here. So we're going to use a mascara here that has a sort of classic brush. This is called Masterpiece Max Mascara. So if you look down for me... Now I'm going to wedge this just right in the centre of the lashes. So a nice thin brush so it stops the mascara going onto your lid when you apply your mascara.
Which always happens to me. I literally always have to take a cotton bud and clean it up and tidy it up. Because I do try and get it so close to the root of the lashes that it inevitably always ends up on my lid, almost like a liner.
Yep. And then you have to readjust your eyeshadow and then it's just annoying and you get frustrated. So yeah, use a smaller brush always. You tend to use bigger wands.
Yeah.
Yeah, use a smaller wand, it makes such a difference. And the reason I'm using two mascaras is just because I love the difference in brush. And it is the brush that makes a difference when applying your mascara. You can have a great formula mascara. Depending on the brush you use, it can have a really difference in effect. Wider spread bristles apply more product. Or dense bristles. Apply the mascara much more lightly to the lashes so you don't get a thicker effect, it's more delicate. So that's, you know, a nice mascara application in itself. Okay, so the second mascara wand is one shaped like this, and it's got a very flat part to the wand with no bristles. So what that allows me to do is just put mascara in quite a heavy manner at the root of your lashes. That's why it's called Lash Crown.
So that's just the little bit at the end that you're using?
The little bit at the end, as you can see now, I'm using, just brushes it through. But the flat part is just like, you know, a stick. And in fact, back in the day, they used to apply their mascara with a very flat stick.
Hang on a minute. Let me watch you do this.
Okay. So, mascara there.
Yeah.
So the base of the mascara, just at the root, I put the bare wand to the root. And that really helps boost the centre lashes, most importantly. It really gives them support to lift, so that when you look in the mirror, you can see the tip of those lashes.
That is amazing.
If you can't see the tip of your lashes, keep trying to push them up, because that's the one way that you're going to open up your eyelashes. And if you've got really straight lashes, the best way to do that is use a waterproof mascara, because the waterproof mascara stops the humidity going into the lashes and allowing them to drop. So you'll get much more lift throughout the day, much more continued lift in your lashes by using a waterproof mascara, which I don't think many people realise.
No, I didn't know that. So do you know what I do midway through the day, which will probably tell me off, but I get the old eyelashes curlers out again and I gently wedge it in and just give them a really gentle, so then it just re-lifts them again.
Yeah.
I know that there's a fear that once it's got product on your lashes that it could make them more brittle perhaps.
Yeah. Well, maybe just check that the rubber isn't got too much product or not. The rubber's got a little bit of oil on it so that it won't cling. Or just take them between your thumb and forefinger.
And just
pinch lashes
up.
Just in the centre there.
Yeah,
if I'm on a shoot, I'll pinch the lashes just to really kind of give a lift.
Because you just feel like your eyes are automatically more open and you look more alert. And I just think, I mean, I always put two coats of mascara on anyway. I just think there's no point just putting one coat on.
Well, what that does is it allows the mascara fibres to link together. So you put your first coat on and then you put the second coat on, and then all the fibres in the mascara have something to build on. So it's like building blocks.
And do you think because you're using two Max Factor mascaras, say, for example, you wouldn't use two different brands of mascara because that could maybe mix them up a bit and make them a bit too yucky and gunky and spiky?
Trial and error.
Okay.
Trial and error. And people and women really are quite specific about the wands that they use and the formulas that you use. Once you find a system that works for your lashes, because you might have very long, thin lashes, you can have very long, thick lashes. So it's different for all of us.
Mm.
I just particularly love these
that
two.
That combo is amazing.
Yeah. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the tip now of the Masterpiece Max, and I'm just going to very lightly almost tint your lower lashes. I don't want too much product on them. I can comb them through in a minute just to get a little tint, because that just keeps them nice and open. If I'm feeling really tired, I just put the mascara on my top lashes only, because that gives me a lift, keeps me more awake. Whereas if I want something really open-eyed, doe-eyed, you know, fresh, big eyes, just put a little bit underneath your eyes. So many people don't do that. They get quite worried about mascara. They think they've got sort of like Daisy the Cow eyes and it looks too obvious, but it really doesn't.
I think it's lovely.
Yeah.
It's quite dolly in a really elegant sort of girly way. I think a lot of people also worried about the mascara, you know, sometimes when it drops,
yes,
and that goes back to the base from the beginning, from
yes,
the concealer, and if it's too oily or too greasy,
yeah,
then the makeup is gonna...
Yeah, tubing mascara. Tubing mascara is the best, and if I'm doing you for a red carpet, I would always put tubing mascara on you, because I just know that I don't have to worry about that mascara imprinting or diluting onto
your
skin.
What's tubing mascara?
We'll talk about it in the next video.
I have no idea. I'm like nodding like I know, and I don't know what tubing is. Soon to be revealed.
Right, so moving on to lips.
You've prepped them with Venefect.
Yeah, that is my favourite lip treatment, especially before wearing any colour. It really hydrates the lips, but it also creates a really smooth base for putting any colour on. So if you find that when you put a lipstick on, especially like maybe a liquid lipstick, then you can feel that it can pinch your lips and kind of like take the beauty out of them. So that's a really, really good product, pre-lips. So natural makeup again, but we're going for the longevity. So I'm not just going to put, you know, a bit of gloss on and off you go, because it's going to last about half an hour. I'll do a little combo of these beautiful shades. I'm going to use the Stay Matte by Rimmel. Now, which colours do you like? I think we'll probably
I
go for your
these,
natural
yeah,
lip colour.
A little
colour.
Bit more...
More pinky?
Pinky, yeah.
Okay. So let's have a little play. So we've got... Be My Baby. It's a really beautiful caramel nude. And then, what's this colour? Blush.
Names are important.
Let's have a look. Either one of these, Lisa, I think. Which one do you prefer?
I think I quite like the colour blush. Is that the more pinky one?
Yes.
Yeah.
Go for more pink?
I think so.
Well, why don't we go more pink for the base,
mm-hmm.
and then with...
Yes.
With the beige, we'll go for something a little bit more lighter. With the
balm. Yeah, that one.
Yeah, with the balm we'll go lighter. Stretch your lips for me. Great. Now, when you're using a matte, just make sure you really sort of wedge it in. This one doesn't dry too quickly, so you've got lots of playtime. But using a liquid matte lipstick, this really helps you shape your lips without having to worry too much about a liner. It's creamier, so it glides on, especially if you've got fine lines. If you stretch your lips nice and bright, you don't, you've got great lips. And I really prefer just to get a lovely rounded Cupid's bow. I don't like it too arched, so just pull that round. This is a great colour. Just enough pink. Sometimes the beigey nudes can drain you.
Mm.
Nice, you've got a strong eye, maybe a lot of warmth in the cheek. But
yeah, I like that look. If it's a really lovely dark eye, then you've got a very nude. But sometimes you just want a bit more
rub
warmth.
That together, yeah. So you see that it just softens slightly.
But it is quite dry.
I would never suggest that you wear that by itself.
Mm.
That's our base. So
right.
That's our base. That's the kind of new way to shape your lips if you don't want to use a liner.
Okay.
And I love it. But I would always, always combine it with a balm.
Okay. Good
or
to know.
Or you can even, like, if I'm wearing a red lipstick out in the evening, I'll always do a liquid lip first and then I'll put a really hydrating lipstick over the top. It lasts longer. You don't get that kind of graduation of colour as it falls off. It's a really nice sort of modern combination.
Great, especially if you're drinking or at a dinner party,
yes.
or an event or something. Great.
Yeah, perfect for you at an event. Right, so let's go.
Because I drink a lot.
For more nude shade.
Of water.
Okay, so let's go in with Spotlight Sheer. Lip cushion and stretch. Let's see how that layers over. Oh, yes, that's beautiful.
Mmm.
Yeah, I think the brown one would have taken the pink undertones away.
That is so pretty.
I love these because you can just have them in a handbag. You can do it. You don't need a mirror. It's just, you always need moisture for your lips. It's just always nice to have a bit of colour.
And we can just use it straight from, with the applicator
yeah.
that it comes with, rather than having to stick a lip brush with us.
Okay, just lips together really nice and relaxed for me. And I'm just going to push it right to the edge here just to capture the light. And that makes your lips look fuller. Fabulous. That was a great combination. I'm pleased we did that.
I love it. A little bit of hair. That is perfect.
I'm thrilled you love
Look
it.
Look how she's transformed my face. You should subscribe to Caroline.
So if you want to discover more about the lovely Lisa Snowden, then look below in the description box and it'll have a link to her amazing beauty blog. Also is a list of all the products that we've used for this look. So anyway, please subscribe.
Yes.
And we're going to be back soon with a few more films.
Yes, we are.